Right, guys, in this demonstration, what we're going to do is we're going to be mixing Deep House. So, what I've got to try and, or what I'm going to try and do here, is have two tracks talking to each other during the mix. Now, let's, first of all, talk about this. Bit of a dodgy angle there, isn't there, really? Let's just put that up there. Okay. Now, many a time I've said, never, and I repeat, just do not do it. Have vocals over vocals, even if they're in the same key. It's the same artist. Happens to be a different song. Just don't do it. Because what you're putting over to the public is this mishmash of sort of talking, singing, vocals, and you can't understand what's going on. The analogy I'll give you, as I've said before, it's a bit like having three people in a room, one person trying to understand the conversation of the other two while they're both talking at the same time. It just doesn't work. But what you can do is, if you're going to mix vocals with vocals, is have them so they are almost short phrase mixing together. So, for example, one track says something for, say, two bars, and then there's a break, and then the other track says sing something for two bars, or one bar and one bar. Now that is actually a really good mix. And I remember listening to a mix like that in the early 80s by, there was Unique, What I've Got Is What You Need, L-O-V-E, Love. I mean, the DJ was really good. Then they used vinyl. There were no programs. You had to do it on vinyl, and the mix was seamless. It worked perfectly. So what I've got here is I've got two very good, deep, sort of garagey tracks. And I'm going to try and give a demonstration of not using vocals, but sort of mixing the melodies and chopping from one to the other. Now, track here on the right is Nick Berringer, and I'll tell you what it's called now. Hold on. Let's just, if I do that and then do that, it should give me Sub-Zero. It's the original mix. This one here is Promenova. It's entitled It's Gonna Be. It's the original mix as well. They are both very, very good. So I'm just going to put that there like that. Right, now then, I'll play a bit of the Promenova first. Very nice, very deep, very soulful. Okay, so you get a general idea. All right, also, when you are mixing in key, you may think that if you have, say, a track that's in B major and you mix another one that's in B major, it'll work perfectly. But what you have to think of as well, I'm sorry to spoil your party, but quite a few tracks have different keys during the course of the track. So, for example, if you're mixing a track in, for example, A7, and the other one's in A7, the first track in A7 may jump to A8, or may jump to B7. So go from a minor key to a major key. So if you are then, maybe, if you think about it, if you go from, if the track itself goes from A7 to B7, and at that point you have decided to mix in another track which happens to be 8A, then it's highly likely there could be a key clash, all right? And you need to look at a track, there's a program called Mixed in Key, Camelot Wheel, and I'm not going to delve into that at the moment, but it's something where your ears start working, or should do anyway. Okay, so that you have to be really careful of as well. Now, what I've got, I've set a cue point here, which is A. Okay. Green flag. Now listen. Okay, from that melody, there's a break. And then the melody comes back in again. Break. there, melody comes back in again. All right, let's listen to this track here. Not that one, this one. Not even that one. This one here, Nick Behringer, Sub-Zero, thank you. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, so again, this is a bit of a demonstration. If I really studied at this and I had my headphones on and I took a great deal of time, we could get it, well, not perfect. Nothing's perfect. Not even computers can get something perfect. Perfection is like me when I'm quiet, because people sort of can do stuff then. Okay. I'm sure there's something funny there. Nope, absolutely not at all. Right, so from A is the beginning of a new phrase. So if we go slightly back, you'll see what I mean. This is my A point. Go back a bit. It's almost like a small break. Straight over to that. Beat comes in. You got that from this track. I want to emphasise that because I'm taking away the bass on that track now. Still in the background. Bang, straight in. Okay, so let's break it down. What exactly happened there? Not a lot, really. What happened was we had that so what I was doing, I was just adding that a tiny, tiny part of the track. And then as the mix progressed, I added a little bit more and a little bit more and a little bit more over that track. And then as soon as the bass came in there, I started to reduce the bass on the track going out. Now, this is, if you think about it, okay, we have a cue point here from A, which is 1 minute and 32 seconds. We've got a cue point here from the beginning, which is at nothing. I've formulated a bit of a mix here, and I've moved the crossfade over at certain times, I've moved the bass down a little bit, and the filter. Now, if you were to do exactly the same mix at exactly the same points, with exactly the same tracks, at exactly the same speed, you could yourself move the bass a little bit further down. You could maybe move the filter up slightly. You may want to move the crossfade over slightly longer. So, no, what I'm trying to say here is no matter how many times this mix is put together by no matter how many DJs, it will always be slightly different. It's a bit like having a pot of white and a pot of red and saying to everyone, make pink. Everyone will make a tiny different shade of pink. Unless, of course, you've got some idiot who just decides to get like a drop of white and just chuck it in with a whole load of red, and then you've just got red with a white dot in it somewhere. Thank you. I will put the names of the tracks in the description, and practice and enjoy. Oh yeah. Oh, by the way, if you do want any Skype lessons from me, check out in the description. There'll be an email where you can sort of get hold of me some way. Thank you. Practice and enjoy.